his only win. Here's Wilson. Drifting in. Oshie from out high with a shot. He scores! TJ Oshie and the Caps take game one.
Well, that's what it feels like to lose a playoff game in overtime, and that's how you feel when you win it. Brendan Dillon made a tremendous block in the defensive zone and allowed the Washington Capitals to exit the zone. Craig Anderson picks up the win. There's Dillon down on the ice. Capitals take the puck and head the other way. And the entry into the offensive zone, Wilson gets that puck over the line before anybody else gets there. Looks like a tip in front, possibly by Dowd, on the shot by Oshie. Quick release from Oshie. There's the stick in front, drops the puck down and through Rask for the overtime winner.
Oh yeah, that gets deflected in front. That's got to be Dowd's goal from what I see. I mean,
hold on, the linesmen here are getting the headset on, which means this could be an offside play. The entire Boston Bruins bench has stayed, with the exception of Tuukka Rask, who immediately went right off the ice and down the tunnel.
The play is under review for offside prior to the goal.
Again, it's not challengeable in overtime. This is initiated by the National Hockey League. But hold on a second.
Yeah, we'll get a good look here and see on the entry. It was Wilson that was carrying the puck. He has to clearly take it into the zone, meaning entirely over the blue line before any other member of the Capitals enters the zone. Watch where the puck is here for Wilson. And does he get it over the line? Looks like he does on that angle, unless there's somebody on the far side. But I think the Capitals are going to have a win here in overtime.
Yeah, this side is fine. Exactly, Jonesy. Unless somebody on the far side is offside, it should be a good goal.
Didn't take long.
After video review, it was confirmed that the play was onside. We have a good goal.
And you've got a game winner for Nic Dowd. Capitals on home ice, 3-2 winners. They lost their goaltender in the first period. They find a way to get the win for Craig Anderson, who will turn 40 on Friday.